Hello, Gulfam ji. Welcome to Tele Tadka.
Hi, Tele Tadka.
Okay. Gulfam ji, tell us about your journey. As I know you, that you were a fashion designer, then getting into acting. How did it happen?
I'm a fashion designer. In 19th year, I was a fashion designer from IIT Calcutta. I started teaching fashion design after that, in the Institute of Fashion Technology. From there, I used to freelance for SMP, for Ashna College, for IITC, National. I used to put time to this, not get time to go to many other institutes in the lectures that I used to have. So I used to teach fashion design. And along with that, I used to do plays. These were individual plays. These were theater groups that I used to join. Mostly they were called as Dopardas, or they were called as street plays, or they were called as fillers. So it was a gang of us youngsters who used to not do it for money. They used to do it for passion. Basically, the plays used to be literature plays. We used to pick up plays from Premchand, we used to pick up plays from Jayashankar Prasai, we used to pick up plays from Sharad Joshi's novels and short stories, and convert them into plays and make these plays. Shifting from group to group, we used to learn different things, different strategies of different groups. So working with Pandit Satyadev Bhuri, I have worked on costumes with Makhan Deshpande. So, and then Rangmanch, and then working with Anupam Sham, who I consider my guru when it comes even to facing the camera, because today I am looking at the camera and talking to him. Once upon a time, the camera is really scarce. So, he's the one who got me out of it and talked to me, then take the keys and look at it. How acting happened is a very interesting thing. I was doing fashion designing, and I was designing for a few shows on TV, along with Mr. Rajendra Deora, that is most popularly known as Rajendra Deora, but the whole behind the scenes is handled by Mr. Rajendra Deora. Now, Mr. Rajendra Deora took me on his board as a designer for this movie. From there, I went to Shagun, Shakala, Nakamunika, Theatre Group. Once you plunge yourself into designing, then you don't bother whether you actually design or you just doing styling, because you want to give you 100% input. With Shagun, Shakala, Nakamunika, and Theatre Group, I was full-fledged 100% into it, and I was doing styling for them, hardly coming home at 1:30 and then again going for the 6 o'clock morning show. Fortunately, unfortunately, I had a trip with Mr. Rajendra Deora, and we parted ways. At the same time, I was doing a play called Abhinavati, and that was the reason why I had a trip with him, because I couldn't communicate properly, we couldn't be on the same page when it came to designing, okay. And given my passion, which was very clear from day one, to that this is what I'm going to do and this is what I have been doing forever. But anyway, that's a long time ago, and in a good way, every cloud has a silver lining. It turned out to be a boon for me because I was doing a play called Abhinavati by Harishankar Prasai. And that's when Ram Gopal Verma's assistant team had to come to see that play through a friend of ours, and one of the assistants, Surya, told me, why don't you do a role in our film, why don't you come to audition? And I said, I don't know what to do, I have never done it. Give it a shot, and that shot turned out to be a series of archeries. So I did Ekasenathi. Fortunately, unfortunately, while doing Ekasenathi, I was also doing a few ads. I did 7 to 9 ads at that time, I did a stretch, earning good money out of it. And with that, when I did Ekasenathi, I was called in for a daily soap. Now, daily soap is like churn. Once you get into a daily soap, right from lipstick till the day, I'm doing daily soap. Last year again, I tried my hand at films, and fortunately, the first audition that I went for was Kalash. I got selected. The next week I went to Mood. I was selected. Third week I went for Kya Super Cool and I got selected. Kya Super Cool being the last one, got released first. Got released second, sorry. Mood got released first. Kya Super Cool and got released second. And Kalash is on the news now. And I have signed a couple of things.
Do you believe that there is always a first time? For everything?
There's always a first time and there's always a second chance for everything.
So if I may ask you that, what was your emotions running through your heart when you first time you faced the camera? actually.
That same emotion runs through my heart and now, and right now it's happening to me. I feel I'm kind of collapsing all unconscious because I might not be able to deliver the dialogues. I'm fumbling, which I'm doing. I will falter, I will use the wrong English, use the wrong Hindi, use the wrong grammar, use the wrong diction, give the wrong look, confuse my co-artist, fail my director. And in a way, I think that's been good for me as an actor, because that only makes you better. Even when you hear that action, you can't hear anything else. Because after that action, you want to put in so much of yours into that performance of yours, that 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 2 minutes, or a minute scene, or even 10 second scene, that you don't hear anything. At that time, if 10 people are dancing in front of me, or people are making passing, or people are laughing, or there's a lot of sound in the background, you'll never hear me saying, cut, 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 sir, kuch awaaz aa rahi hai, kaun baat kar raha hai. That never happens with me, thank God, it's more verses, but that's how it is.
Okay, now let me ask you about the writing. Your turn as a writer also now.
Yes, I used to always write short stories, like we always do. Every person lies, and lies are nothing but stories.
Okay.
Stories are what you mean. You lie the first time to your mother, and that is the cruel, bitter fact of your life. You lie the first to your mother, to your father, to your teachers. Teach you the base, the foundation of your life. I know someone who's been lying about their homework for over a year. I couldn't do it because they had guests. I couldn't do it because my neighbor's cat ate my homework. I've got that kind of excuses too. But no, I'm not speaking about the person in reference over here. But yes, you end up lying a lot of times, and lying takes a lot of story making. You have to think on your feet. So when you do it professionally. So you lie all the time. When you see films, they're lies. When you see books, they're lies. They're not, they are said to be fictions. Fiction is the fragment of your mind, your imagination. And imagination is not real. So what is not real is false. What is not true is lie. So true stories dramatically performed is again a lie, because it is not true.
Yes.
Even you read the newspaper, it is not 100% truth. So there is nothing but lies, 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 and storytelling, storytelling, storytelling. So rather than telling stories and getting the sin without any money, I would take the sin and take the money.
So, which are you writing an author or something?
I am writing a book.
Book?
I started a book.
Yep.
It's a chick lit, a girly girly book.
Okay.
And I would like to write something serious. So I have a few things churning in my mind. Right now, I'm concentrating on my screenplay dialogue and writing for my next film, which I'm just going forward to. Your wishes, the fan wishes, everyone wishes, family wishes, everyone.
Yes.
Every positive energy in the universe falls in place, and I'll be soon presenting you all some fragment of my imagination. Not that I have not done it before. I have written a few gags for Comedy Circus 1 along with Imam and Dharampal and the group. I have written this Malika Shiravat with Jennifer Lynch being associated with the best part of the film, that is the writing. I have written that and presented it here. But I think now is the time when I give you all the 100% of what you have to think and write and present.
I heard that you paint also, being a fashion designer, of course it's a your forte. So if you can tell us about your painting, what inspire you when you paint?
A lot of people will ask me, because I'm a fashion designer, that's why I've got a good hand. But that's not the thing. You have a good hand or you don't have a good hand. I believe anyone who can write from 1 to 9 can draw something. So fashion design is all like geometry. It's all about measurements. So once you do those things according to measurements, you end up doing good drawings. But drawing or painting with your memory about things that you've not seen, only heard or hearsay or fragments of your imagination are weird things that you see in your mind. When you see them in your mind and your hands coordinate such that you bring them down to paper. There have been instances where I have sketched something in 10 minutes for a person who's sitting in front of me. I have got a pen and a paper. I've sketched a face, but that happens sometimes. Sometimes I will just attempt to do it and it does not happen. So it's all about your mind, your coordination with your hand. You will ask any painter or any writer. yourself holding your ears and things and you look karke dikhao to kar sakte ho. I find it very funny when you go for auditions and people come there and there are newcomers who come there who've been associated with drama as a play and everything and they've been joking and laughing at home and they know that they are an actor. But aap unko bolte ho karke dikhao, wo kya karke dikhayenge? There are so many things that they've done, but at that moment there are 10 things on their mind. Next thing karunga, kaun sa karunga, kya karunga, and then they fail. So the same thing with a painter. You can't tell a painter, oh you sketch, chalo meri face bana de. How is it possible? It's a creative thing, and creativity is inclination. It's like your mental drug. If you're not on the mental high, you can't deliver that.
Yes.
So it's simple as that.
Okay, so I saw your painting of Ganesh ji. You did it with thumb. It is a thumb print.
Thumb and fingerprints. I used to do it. I have done it on oil canvas piece. That was the first oil paint I attempted because I didn't know how to do oil painting.
Okay.
But I knew that every layer of oil takes some time to dry up.
Drive.
So initially I was very impatient and I went on messing. And that mess turned out so beautiful that after 2 days I just gave it a rest. And on the 4th day I saw the different colors come out of it. So I got the technicalities of how oil comes out and it gives the impression on your canvas. And then by the time I finished in 8 days, I had a very beautiful painting. That's again a monster.
Okay. It's a pleasure talking to you, Gulfam ji. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.